Hi everybody. I want to just talk briefly about igneous rocks today. I want to go over a little bit of the vocabulary, and then I want to show you how to read the igneous rocks chart in your reference table on page 6. So the main thing to remember about igneous rocks is they form when magma gets so hot that it melts and it's actually liquid rock. And this happens at really high temperatures. We're talking over about 1200 degrees Celsius, which is really, really, really hot, way hotter than Fahrenheit. As the rock material cools, it gains certain characteristics that I'll talk about a little bit more when I go over the chart. If it forms quickly, it's an extrusive rock. That's on the surface. That's in like lava flows and stuff like that. If it forms really slowly, it's intrusive. And that's when the large crystals can form, and that can take millions, you know, hundreds of thousands to millions of years. But really the key vocabulary that you want to remember is anything that has to do with melting and solidifying definitely is an igneous rock. So let's take a look at the chart. This chart here is found on page 6 of your reference table, and it talks about the igneous rock schemes. So the first part, it's in three parts, and the first part I want to talk about is right here in the middle, and it has to do with the colors, the density, and the composition of these rocks. Now, you'll see some vocabulary words like mafic and felsic, all right? Those are important, but let's just start off with some of the names of the rocks are on the top. So for example, when we look at gabbro would be a dark rock, higher density, and mafic, which means it has iron and magnesium in it, because it's on this side of the table. Okay, if we look at over here, if we look at say granite, it's on the left side of the table, so it would be a lighter color, lower in density, and felsic rock, rich in silicon and aluminum. So that's how that works. At the bottom, you'll see this sort of this part right down here, and this is the minerals that are found in each of these types of rocks. So to look at basalt again, we find, you know, if we want to know what minerals are in basalt, we go down, we see that these minerals over here are in basalt. And a little bit of amphibole, a little bit of plagioclase feldspar, and a teeny little bit of biotite, because if we're looking down on this end, you see that a line would go through those minerals as well. Same thing with if we look at granite over here, we look down, we just draw our finger down, we see that granite has quartz, potassium feldspar. It also has some plagioclase feldspar, biotite, and amphibole. All right. Now, the other thing is, though, when we look at granite, it has these minerals. It does not have any of these minerals in it because those minerals aren't directly below it. All right. Now, the last part is this up here, and this has to do with the texture of the minerals, which then in turn talks about the environment of formation. So as the minerals up at the top up here are fine grain. If you look up here, the words are glassy and fine grain, and that means they were extrusive. All right, and what I like to remember is extrusive has the EX in it, means that it exited the earth, all right? When it exits the earth, that means it cooled really quickly. And fine grain rock resulted, didn't have a lot of time for the grains to form. When we look down a little bit farther, all right, we look down here, we see that there's coarse and very coarse, which are large numbers right here, all right? And they form intrusively, which I remember as inside the earth. intrusive inside. Since they formed inside, it took them a long time to form, and they have large crystals. So there you have it. General overview of page 6, the igneous rock chart in your reference table. And I want to just leave you with the idea here that there's many different ways that the rocks can appear and still have the same minerals in them, and it's just really determined by the way that they formed. Okay, so if I have some felsic rocks, like this is a granite, okay, you can see this is a granite, you can see the coarse grains, each of the shiny parts, like right there and like there, those are the grains. Okay, this rock has similar mineral characteristics as this rock. This is pumice. Okay, the granite here in that I'm jiggling up and down here formed over a really long time. It's an intrusive. Okay, and this pumice here is very light. It's actually the only type of rock that really floats. You can see the gas pockets in it. Has the same minerals in it, but it formed in a totally different environment, an extrusive environment, where it basically got shot out of a volcano. So same minerals, different formation in the environment can result in very different looking igneous rocks.